Hey, yo, what's up guys, Zaid here. Wanted to bring you another episode on fasting, on how to break your fast, because this is actually a very complicated topic and everybody has their own way of doing it, and I just wanted to clarify what's been working for me and what I am going to be doing and how I am going to be breaking my fast every single day to achieve the results that I'm looking forward to getting, which is to keep lean, keep a good amount of muscle, and at the same time have the explosive performance or the endurance that I require. First, I'm a carnivore guy. I really do like my carnivore diet. I know there's a lot of benefits to it. I know I've tried them out. I've tried the carnivore diet several times. That's the way I kind of choose to live my lifestyle. But at the moment, it is not what I require all the time. I don't require to be eating meat 24/7 all the time. At least not right now, not at this moment. Right now, I need a little bit more explosiveness. As I explained before, I need a little bit more carbohydrates in my life. I will be fasting, as I've told you guys before, with a 16 to 8 hour window. So 16 hours I will be fasting and 8 hours I will be eating. That's when I will be feasting. But it's imperative that my first meal is done right. And this is the reason why. The fast has to be broken with a lean meal and with some high glycemic carbohydrates, which is what everybody, or what most people wouldn't tell you. High glycemic carbohydrates seem to be the demon, you know? But that's not the situation, not in this case at least. First, we gotta kind of go in depth into what a fast does. And what a fast does is basically, it helps us make our insulin levels hypersensitive in a sense. So again, insulin is not bad for us. It's just a matter of how we control it. What ends up happening is when we have that amount of insulin rolling around, it opens up the cell. When we open up, a lot of things can go in it. So if the first thing you deposit in those cells is fat, guess what it's gonna start using? It's gonna start holding on to fat when it goes ahead and it closes back down again. So what we need to do, or what I do, is I like to go ahead and use this time right after fasting to go ahead and give my body what I wanted to use. Let's say I was just strictly doing keto, then yes, I would probably go ahead and give it some fat if I was already highly fat adapted. But at the moment, I'm wanting to use carbs. I want the best of both worlds. So this is the way I take this. What I'll do is, yeah, I'll give it protein, but the protein has to be lean and the carbohydrates have to be high glycemic. I'll give a couple of examples on both of those right now. And then after those meals, several hours after, that's when we go ahead and we have our regular, I guess in this case, more carnivore-ish meals, my ferments or my fruits to hold me off for the rest of the day. So what are some of the proteins that I will be using? So these are very simple, like the leaner the cut, the better. Some good examples, I believe, are chicken breast. Turkey is also a good option. Pork chops, leaner pork chops, you know. Pork tenderloin is also a really good option. Beef jerky, it's actually a perfect time to have beef jerky. Beef jerky tends to be very lean. Beef tenderloin, you know, those types of cuts of meat. Also, if you're doing fish, a little bit more fish oriented, sockeye salmon is great. Sole, halibut, cod, those are all great options as well. And tuna, which is great because it has a good amount of selenium. And coming straight out of the fast, like that's something that we definitely wanna go ahead and replenish. Same goes with chicken breast and turkey. It has a good amount of thiamine, which is also very, very good for you, especially after a fast. Every now and then I'll break my fast with protein shake, but if I do break it with a protein shake, I'm gonna go ahead and break it with an isolate. Once again, we want very lean. Protein isolate is one of the best things, and what I usually add to it is EAAs, essential amino acids, not the same as BCAAs. There's a complete difference on those. I'll add the protein isolate, the EAAs, and if I have the resources to go ahead and do it, I'll add the collagen as well. One of the ones that I use for my protein powders is IsoPure. They have a really good breakdown of where everything comes from. It's a really good protein powder, I believe. Doesn't have a bunch of fillers, doesn't have a bunch of stuff. And for collagen, Great Lakes, that's the one that I use all the time. It's also a really good supplement if I'm gonna be using one. As far as EAAs, do your due diligence on them. I go ahead and I use the one from Keon. It's actually by Ben Greenfield, Keon EAAs. Those are awesome. I really use them. I really like them. They help out with conserving muscle, which I always think is a great thing. Now, as far as carbs, what am I going to be eating for carbs? Two things that I am going to be using and that I would recommend would be, one, if you're going to go the traditional carb route, high glycemic. That way it spikes our insulin and we can get whatever we want into the cell. In this case, protein, EAAs. And if you want to add a supplement such as fish oil, get some magnesium, you know, whether it's malate or glycinate, cod liver oil right now is the perfect time. And the carbs of choice that I'm going to be using are going to be things such as apples, grapefruits, strawberries, mangoes, pears, if right now they're in season, so it's perfect. Not a lot, just like a pear, just like a couple of berries, you know, we don't need a huge amount of these. And if I am going to be going the more traditional carb route, what I'm going to be doing is maybe using rice cakes. Rice cakes are great. Potatoes, baked potatoes are going to be good, especially if you boil them first and then bake them. And that's really all the things that I would really consume when I'm breaking a fast. I don't like having a lot of options. I think it just makes it a little bit better for me. Like, options are great in a lot of situations, but the easier it is, the less things there are to think about, the more likely it is that I'm gonna be doing it. Leaner cuts of meat, something high glycemic. The way this might look, it might look like, you know, you get some chicken breast when you go ahead and you break your fast. Just a small amount. You don't need to be eating great amounts of this. Just a small amount, some chicken breast, and maybe a pear, you know, half a pear even. You know, we just need to spike those insulin levels. That way we can go ahead our desired outcome from breaking our fast. We just need to do it in a smart way. There's different ways of doing things, but this is the way I do it. I know I've gotten great results in the past, and this is the way I'm gonna be breaking my fast moving forward. Something that you really wanna avoid is just heavy starches, high amounts of fats, and just really hard digesting carbs. That's exactly what you don't want. Make sure that you avoid those, keep it as lean as possible, or in my situation, for the goals that I'm trying to reach, I'm gonna try to avoid those. But in any case, guys, just wanted to give you a quick update on how I'm gonna be breaking my fast. Hopefully you like this content. And if you really do like this content, I would really urge you to smash that like button. It really helps me out. Go ahead and press that subscribe button if you wanna keep on seeing content such as this. And definitely leave a comment down there. Let me know what you guys think about this video. Zaid, out.
Peace.